Toxic theater fog at Six Flags Fiesta Texas and SeaWorld. PM2.5 is very small particulate matter, also known as air pollution. No one should breathe in PM2.5, especially outside the green zone of the air quality index, which goes from 0 to 50. Over the last 2 years, I had been getting very sick mysteriously, including trouble breathing and immune system overreaction to new allergies. Research shows air pollution is linked to increasing allergies and poor health, so I bought a sensor from a website. There's many air quality sensors that can be bought online. I would like to encourage everyone to hold the theme parks responsible for the air pollution they are blasting on guests and workers for long periods of time. Outside on the train ride that day, the PM2.5 was only at 13. The air quality index was in the green. While sitting in the back of the Rockville Theater by a frequently opened door, the PM2.5 was 158. That is very bad air. It would have been much higher if I'd have sat in the front. Zaragoza Theater is larger than Rockville, but surprisingly, the air pollution is worse and even reaches all the way into the lobby. The building never gets aired out with pure air, but no one should be breathing in the fog anyway, indoors or outdoors. Glycol-based fogs are not safe. They should have been banned decades ago. The air pollution from highway traffic doesn't even reach these levels of air pollution. After repeated visits to verify my sensor readings, I wrote letters and emails to the EPA, OSHA, and the health department, with pictures included. They all dismissed these concerns, even though these agencies are supposed to enforce that workers and the public are safe from environmental hazards. Six Flags did not stop blasting air pollution, even though OSHA believed they did and closed the complaint. After this OSHA response was sent and the complaint closed, I visited Six Flags again. The sensor showed even worse levels of PM2.5 than before. The sensor maxed out at 999 PM2.5, and after that visit, I became much sicker. My immune system has become dysregulated, among other issues, and that's a very difficult thing to treat. Research is starting to verify theater fog is very hazardous. PM2.5 is already known to be hazardous to health. These black boxes are all around the park. They blast glycol-based theater fog on guests and workers, especially around Halloween, but fog is used year-round. Rockville and Zaragoza theaters are full of air pollution and are toxic even to walk into. Long-term health effects of chronic exposure to theatrical fog and haze include reduced lung function, cardiovascular diseases such as hypertension, heart attacks and stroke, immune system dysregulation, increased infections, and increased cancer risk over time. And there's a website that has a research on those issues. The EPA lists harmful effects of PM2.5, including premature death, non-fatal heart attacks, irregular heartbeat, aggravated asthma, decreased lung function, increased respiratory symptoms, and difficulty breathing. This chart and this information can be found on this website. And the ranges for the AQI values are also displayed. What is the general duty clause? So by definition, this means that employers must protect employees from any serious hazard once they're aware of it, whether OSHA's rules specifically address it or not. OSHA is neglecting their duties. Theater fog is hazardous air pollution. The public and most workers are unaware of the hidden danger of theater fog. Workers can submit complaints to OSHA, even anonymously, but don't wait until you get sick or worse. SeaWorld uses the same air-polluting theater fog, but Six Flags uses much more of it. Using theater fog indoors at the levels they use is very unhealthy for workers and guests. People do not expect to be blasted by air pollution going to family-friendly parks. People are getting sick and worse. Theater fog should not be used at all in air that people breathe. Thank you for listening, and please spread the message.